Hi, everyone. Welcome to Pivotal Stories here at SpringOne Platform 2018. I'm Jeff Kelly, and my guest is Ryan Fox, who's responsible for platform engineering at Manulife John Hancock. Ryan, welcome.
Thank you.
So what are some of the drivers of Manulife's digital transformation?
We really wanted to think about how do we better leverage technology to help our customers. And it really is important for us as part of that to own technology as a differentiator. It's been very vocal from the top of being a tech-driven company. And so our tech strategy is really about starting to bring that to life and bring that as a capability to our businesses to impact our customers in new ways.
And so we chatted a little bit ahead of time, and you talked a little bit about speed to market and iterating quickly and getting new ideas to your customers quickly. Talk about why that's so important in this current environment.
In this world where expectations are changing by the day with our customers, we really wanted to take a starting point of assuming that our customer knows best, and we're going to know them better by getting closer to them and experimenting with them. And so the more that we can be in market with them, trying new things, testing out and really driving experiments, the better we'll get to know them, the better we'll serve them. And so that time to market of how we think about an idea and how quickly we can get it from a customer really becomes that cycle time of experimentation for the company. And so a lot of our technology strategy is really centered around how do we shorten that time to market and give our GMs new levers to experiment and try new things with our customers.
So we chatted about this concept of business agility. In addition to software agility, software development agility, can you talk about what that means at Manulife and how does one agile software development support agility in the larger business?
We think agile software development is really important and it really serves the foundation for this, but we don't think it's enough. Because it's great to move quick within technology, but if you're not reaching out to your customers and changing the way you build products and build experiences, you're really leaving a lot of the value on the table. And so when we talk about Agile within the company, we include the business. We include operations, we include sales and support, and we think those are all important pieces to think about how do those functions work in an Agile way. And that takes more time, and we think it's not possible without technology. It's not possible without Agile software underpinning those experiments. But if we want to get the most out of our technology and really focus not just on how we build, but what we build, then it really comes back to agility throughout the business and really a mindset of experimentation and being able to say, we don't know, let's try it. I see a lot of our focus around the platform really driving cost down of experimentation. So that becomes a more frequent statement within the company.
Right, that's interesting because it's not just about the ability to experiment, but the buy-in from the top to enable that kind of culture, right?
Right.
So you mentioned the platform, and I know you've embraced this platform as product approach. Talk about the benefits of that and what it means for both the operations team as well as the developers. Do the operations team now look at developers essentially as their customers? And then taking that one step further, how does that benefit Manulife's actual customers?
Sure. So when we started the journey and we started talking about having a global development platform, there was a lot of hesitation. There was silos and people thinking, well, we don't share a lot of customers amongst our markets, so why is it important that we share technology? And as we've gone through this journey, people have started to realize the value of thinking about of the platform as a product and that evolution. And part of that is the community that builds upon it, right? And the ability to be working on the same technology and therefore be able to have conversations across markets, right? And whether that's with engineers in Ho Chi Minh City asking a question and someone in Montreal responding, that's really started to amplify some of the value of thinking about this as a holistic product, right? And then when it actually gets into the developers and some of our ambitions around having development as an in-house capability, we know the experience they have matters. And it can become a powerful recruiting tool because developers want to have an impact. They want to be able to see their impact on our customer base and quickly. And so the more that we think about the platform as that opinionated product, that where the opinionations are helping them be more successful, that are paving paths that are easier in a company that can be complex. If someone could get code to production in their first week, that becomes a really big motivator to attract talent but also retain them, right? And so we think about that productization of it as a way to streamline how they interact and how they build good code and ship it to our customers and ultimately reach our millions of customers, right? And that's a big attractor as we start to think about recruiting is we have access to a lot of customers, we have access to a lot of data. And so the more that we can make it easy for them to access those customers and access their data with their code, that becomes really important as a recruiting proposition. Mm-hmm.
In terms of offering a consistent platform, a consistent experience for your developers, whether they're in Ho Chi Minh City, Montreal, or anywhere else in the world, and making sure best practices are being followed, how do you balance that with giving those developers the agility they need to experiment and take risks? Because of course they're closest to the customers in their different markets. So how do you balance that consistency, making sure best practices are being followed, but also giving developers some level of autonomy to take some risks, yep. do some experiment?
Yeah, we talk a lot about it. We talk about that global versus local mix quite a bit as an organization, right? Of how do we leverage the scale of the company, but really maintain that local innovation and that view that innovation is going to happen closest to the user and closest to the customer. And we think about that both from a platform perspective and our users being developers and embrace the innovation that they're going to have and want to contribute back to the platform, but also with customers, our ultimate end customers. And so I think part of it is conversation, part of it's having common measurements and thinking about even if we're going to delegate and let people have some freedom, let's operationalize guardrails or let's put common views of quality in so that when there are issues, we have a common fact base that we're talking from, right? And so it's not a debate of, oh, is this your data or is it mine? And they tell different stories. We want to make sure we have a consistent view as we start to federate that out. And that's an evolving piece for us. But it really is about maintaining that local presence and that local flexibility. And we see from our developers that we earn the right to be more opinionated in those areas, right? And we started with some really core concepts within the platform, but over time they asked for our opinions. They asked for our views. They asked for us to productize things that were once considered a local responsibility because they realized it really helps them. Right, and they realize it helps their peers, and as they onboard new people, that it helps them get going quicker on the platform.
Right, it makes me think of James Waters, one of our executives, and he talks about working above the value line. And for developers, they don't want to deal with some of the infrastructure concerns, some of the platform concerns. They want to focus on their applications. And it sounds like the partnership you've developed with your developers allows you to make decisions about what part of the platform is really going to be below that value line so they can do their best work.
Yeah, it's a big part of our product group within the platform team is thinking about and working with those developers to get their feedback and where do they think we should go next, letting them help us drive the platform evolution, right? And we think about it as kind of a foundational component in the platform overall, but a foundational community that really supports it.
So I know it's still early in Manulife's transformation efforts, but are there any early successes you could share with us? You know, that could be maybe some new applications you developed or the number of developers developing on the platform. Any kind of metrics or success measures you could share?
Yeah, so we've got a couple hundred developers working on the platform day in and day out today, which is a great start, a long way to go from where we want to be, which is a few years to go. But really frequently getting value out of the platform. They're pushing thousands of times a month. And that really is a market change from the past. And so that has really empowered them and gotten them to invest more time and energy into adopting the platform more holistically. We've got almost 100 apps in different shapes and sizes running on the platform today, which is a great start as well. So we're well into the journey, but a long way to go still.
Fantastic. And as we wrap up, so what's on your priority list? Let's say the next 6-12 months. You mentioned ramping up, getting even more developers on the platform. What's your priorities?
Yeah, a lot of it is about growth and depth and making sure that as our business scales up and our technology groups scale up, their expectations that we're able to meet them, that we're staying ahead, that we're really focused on that operational readiness and how we scale that out and some great new announcements coming today around that will help us make that easier for some of the components, which is great. But also that quality aspect, right? How do we drive more quality development within the organization and not from the view of control, but through empowerement and visibility? And we really spend a lot of time trying to take less control and provide more visibility instead and help people make the right decisions and make the easy thing the right thing to do.
I think that's a great note to wrap up on. Good advice. Brian, thanks so much for joining us. Really appreciate it.
Appreciate it.